Oh, hey, a new Warframe just came out in the new Deadlock Protocol update. Protea, a support Warframe with time-manipulating powers. Alongside her, there's also a couple of new weapons. Her signature sidearm, the Velox submachine gun. A glaive called the Zoris that has some interesting qualities I'll get to later. And two new corpus weapons. The Stalta, a rifle that also fires exploding radioactive rods. And the Strofa, a rad-looking gunblade. And since all of them are somewhat interlinked in how you farm for them, I'll cover them all in this video. So let's start with the blueprints. The blueprint for Protea is acquired by completing the new Deadlock Protocol quest that you can find in your codex. As a prerequisite for doing the quest, you simply need to have first done the Vox Solaris quest in Fortuna. Deadlock Protocol is a fairly low-level affair and shouldn't be too hard to complete. The only thing that might give you trouble is the boss fight against Protea herself inside of the Granum Void, where you have to charge the Zoris and throw it at her at the correct times to prevent her from healing herself. Oh yeah, you just straight up get the Zoris as part of doing the Deadlock Protocol quest. Nothing else required, you just get it. It's a cool glaive. I've also released another video where I show you how to effectively use the Zoris in the Granum Void, so go check that video out if the Protea fight is giving you trouble. Once you've completed the quest, you will get the blueprint for Protea. The blueprint for the Velox you simply buy from the market for 25,000 credits. And the blueprints for the Stalta and the Strofa, you get those as random drops from defeating the newly revamped Jackal in Fossa on Venus. Now that you have all the blueprints, it's time to hunt down the component parts, and all of them are found inside of the Granum Void. The Granum Void is a new area you can access through the Golden Hand portals that you will find in the new Corpus Ship tileset. There will be several Golden Hands in each map, so you won't have to look very hard to find them. In order to enter the Granum Void, you need to first feed a Granum Crown into it, which you get by killing special Treasurer units that will spawn into the mission after a certain amount of time has passed. Within 2 to 4 minutes, in non-endless missions like Capture or Sabotage, and within 5 to 8 minutes, in endless missions like Defense or Survival. They only spawn in missions taking place in the new Corpus Ship tileset, and depending on the level of the mission, they will drop 1 out of 3 different kinds of coins. In levels 1 to 15, they'll drop normal Granum coins. In levels 16 to 30, they'll drop Exemplar Granum coins. And in levels 31 and above, they will drop Zenith Granum coins. Which kind of coin you feed into the Golden Hand will determine the difficulty of the Granum Void mission. And each tier has its own set of rewards that you need to farm. So don't just go for the highest tier. You're gonna need to run all 3 of them to complete these blueprints. There are 4 different nodes where you can get the normal Granum crowns, 2 where you can get the Exemplar Granum crowns, and 4 where you can get the Zenith Granum crowns. Sometimes you can also run higher level versions of these missions, if, for example, they happen to be a nightmare mission or part of a sortie, which will affect which sort of crown the treasurer will drop. When the treasurers were first introduced, you could use a Necros, Hydroid, or Korra for a chance of getting double drops on the crowns, but that quickly got hotfixed and no longer works. However, getting a stack of crowns won't be hard anyway. The reason is that in a 4-person group, only one person needs to donate a crown to let everyone into the Granum Void, while the other 3 get to keep their crown that they got from the treasurer. So you'll rack up a surplus pretty quickly. Which is good! Because once you're done with this farming, those crowns have other uses as well. You can spend them to free Solaris prisoners on the ship, which will reward you with some Solaris United standing, depending on which crown you used to free them. Or to get orbiter decorations by donating them to a Corpus Temple relief that you can sometimes find in Corpus ships. But for now, you will be using them to enter the Granum Void. Once inside the Void, you'll be on a time limit, and you need to kill a certain amount of specters before the time runs out to get the full bonus. You can increase the time by 5 seconds by picking up little pyramids occasionally dropped by the specters, or by 20 seconds by charging up your Zoris and throwing it at the Solaris prisoners you'll find on the map. If you're running solo, you need to get 75 kills, to get the tier 3 reward. And in a 4-person group, the number goes up to 150 kills. And you want to get those tier 3 rewards, because that's how you get the component parts you're looking for. Each level of difficulty has different weapon parts for the Stalta, Strofa, and Velox. And also, an 11.11% chance to reward you with one of the Protea component blueprints. Some things to note about the Granum Void. First, it works like a survival mission with enemy spawns, which means that specters can be cleared quicker and in greater amounts if you huddle together in a tight group. Spread out and you'll most likely fail to get enough kills in time. Second, while most people currently bring so-called nuke frames like Mirage, Revenant, or Mesa to quickly kill things, this mission is designed around using the Zoris, and if you just go in with a Zoris, you can easily get enough kills no matter which Warframe you're using. Again, please take a look at my video showing how to use the Zoris in Granum Void missions to see what I mean. And third, you can get invaded by the Stalker or Zanuka Hunter while you're in the Granum Void, so keep an eye on the clock. One final thing to note is that no matter what the level of the mission is, you can access all three difficulty levels of the Granum Void depending on which coin you're donating. This can be helpful if, for example, all the low-level missions happen to be held by your Kuva Lich, who can and will steal component parts together with other mission rewards. In that case, you can simply farm Granum Crowns from the Lich Control planet, but run the actual Granum Void missions on another planet not controlled by your Lich, to ensure that no rewards will get stolen. Once you have all your components, it's time to start crafting. You'll notice that Protea's components will need a hefty amount of carbides, cubic diodes, and Copernics. You can get these in small amounts from killing Eximus enemies on Ceres, Europa, or Lua respectively. However, that is not an efficient way of getting them. Instead, they are very common and drop in huge amounts from Railjack missions. So if you don't already have them, just join some public Railjack missions and you will have collected thousands of each in no time. And that's all you need to know. Now go out there and bend time to your will.